love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. We show our support for Dee and Emma today by joining together in the prayer in bold type at the top of page 2 of your service sheet. God of wonder and of joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts, and serve you always with willing minds, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please would you stand for our first hymn. In marriage, husband and wife belong to one another, and they begin a new life in the community. It is a way of life that all should honour, and it must not be undertaken carelessly, lightly, or selfishly, but reverently, responsibly, and after serious thought. This is the way of life, created and hallowed by God, that Dean and Emma are about to begin. They will each give consent to the other. They will join hands and exchange solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. Therefore, on this their wedding day, we pray with them that strengthened and guided by God, they may fulfill his purpose for the whole of their earthly life together. First, I am required to ask anyone present who knows a reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. The vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is judge of all and knows all the secrets of our hearts. Therefore, if either of you knows a reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Dean, will you take Emma Louise to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Emma Louise, will you take Dean to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Part for all of you now. Will you, the families and friends of Emma Louise and Dean, support and uphold them in their marriage, now and in the years to come?
We will.
Try it again. In the years to come.
We will.
Marvellous. And a prayer. God our Father, from the beginning, you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessings on Emma Louise and Dee, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our Bible reading today is taken from Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 13. And part of it is actually on the back of your service sheet, which you can read later. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers, and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice. rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Well, I'm sure you'll agree with me that Emma and Dee look really special today. On this day, I know they've been waiting for such a long time. And surrounded as they are by their three boys, it's a lovely occasion. And what a wonderful time to be getting married. It's almost Valentine's Day, and it's also National Marriage Week. So you picked a good time. Love is definitely in the air, as the song goes. If we go in the shops at the moment, they're full of cardboard hearts, flowers, chocolates, special meals for two, and with the prices greatly increased. All full of all the things that they would have you believe are essential for love. But love is more than that. Love is wonderful, but love can hurt. I've just read St. Paul's description of love, which he wrote about in a letter to Corinth, where the people were not sharing love. They were doing lots of other things, but they weren't sharing love. Some of you may remember the Love Is cartoons a few years ago. Love is, and then there'd be a little saying. Love is making you laugh even when it's not that easy. Love is saying, I love you at random moments. Emma and Dean, you do look amazing today, and I know how much time and effort you've gone into to present your outward appearance to make sure you look your best for each other. But God has chosen Emma and Dean individually and loves them unconditionally. Emma and Dean chose each other, and the love that has grown between them means a beginning of a new life today as they become husband and wife. Let's just think about how Paul described love. It's fine, it's lovely. Yeah, that's okay. Love is patient, and they're certainly being patient at the moment, as there are demands from little ones for their attention. Love is patience and understanding when one of you has had a bad day. When the kids haven't behaved, when you've had a bad day at work. Love is kind. It's about considering each other's feelings and needs. Being generous, caring deeply for each other and each other's families. Love is not envious, boastful, arrogant or rude. It's important to understand that you need to give each other space to have your own friends, your own time apart. And that way your love can grow. Love does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in truth. Yes, you will have disagreements, but it's about moving on. Having a disagreement, sorting it out, but then that's the end of it. Not bringing it up on the next occasion to score points or to say, well, I told you so. It doesn't insist on its own way, putting the other person first and not being selfish. For example, hogging the remote control. Using all the hot water. I can see several of you looking at each other. It's not irritable or resentful. Staying calm when you want to scream about something, such as the fact you've let the top off the toothpaste again. The toilet seat up and I've told him to put it down. The washing up's not done. All the children are demanding your attention when you actually want a rest. Emma and love will be shown through their approach to life. Their values and attitudes demonstrating how they will live together in unity and harmony, hoping for the best for each other and learning to work together in the difficult times. The love they have for each other is bound together with God's love. There are three in this marriage: Emma, Dean and God. God will walk alongside you, help you to bear any difficulties, rejoice with you when things are great, and teach you to forgive each other, especially with annoying habits. God will be with you in happy times and sad. I know there are people here who wish to be here today, and we particularly remember Nana, Grant, as she was called. Anything of her fondly, she had looked forward to being here today, but she is now resting in peace. Today may be the best day of your life so far, but I hope you will have better days in the future as your love for each other blossoms. My prayer for you both, as Paul said, is that your love will never end. And now we come to the marriage, the big moment. Nerdine, would you like to come back to the front? Hold the mark, hands down. And yes, you can come as well, isn't it? Liam wants to join in too. That's okay. Do you want to come up here? That's brilliant. That's it. You're still there, and you can see Mummy and Dad. That's fine. Who brings this woman to be married to this man? That's the right hand to Dean. Emma and Dean, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. You face each other. Dean, begin with you. I, Dean, take you, Emma Louise.
I, Dean, take you, Emma Louise.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold. From this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better, for worse,
better, for worse,
for richer, for poorer,
for richer, for poorer,
in sickness and in health,
in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
till death us do part,
death do part,
according to God's holy law,
according to God's holy law,
in the presence of God. I make this vow. Now, Emma, you would take Dean's right hand in your right hand, with your hand on the top, that's it. I, Emma Louise, take. Yes, I, Emma Louise.
I, Emma Louise.
Take you, Dean.
Take you, Dean.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part. According to God's holy law. In the presence of God, I make his vow. He's got them as well. Fantastic. Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Emma Louise and Dean a symbol of ending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they have made this day. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
First of all, thank you all for coming on behalf of me and Emma. Thanks for all the bridesmaids, you all look gorgeous. Thanks Emma, you look gorgeous as well. Thanks Sandra for all the hard work you've done, making the day so special for us both. Thanks Mum and Dad for all the help you've done getting the day special. Thanks Eric for all the help you've done, and thank you all for sharing our special day. And thanks Sam for being the best man. Over to you.
See how the Dean was like, really good speech there, that. Got a lot of water.
Bit loud, Sam.
Right, first and foremost, I've been doing a lot of research on our best man speech at work because I've not really done this before. So I read somewhere online that a best man speech should take no longer than it takes in the groom to make words of the wife. So on that note, ladies and gentlemen, I give you Mr. and Mrs. Jones. Joking aside, for those who don't know me, I'm Sam, Dean's younger, better looking brother. I'd like to start again, everyone. Start by thanking everybody for coming today and sharing what's been the truest special occasion. So the first toast, I'd like to everyone to raise a toast to the most special people in here, the bar staff.
Very good.
In all seriousness, it's been a great honour to be the best man today. Really. I've been really nervous all week thinking about what I'm going to say, so I actually prepared a few lines, believe it or not. And I've been having started in the toilet a few minutes ago, and I feel fucking great. Right, joking aside now. Welcome everyone to the wedding. I know everyone's had a really nice time so far. People have come all over the country today. Manchester, Durham, I've even heard some people have come from Maxfield. Like, generally, thank you from all of us, we really do appreciate it. Like, it's amazing how far people come for a free meal. But, you know. No, on a more serious note, I'd like to say thanks to the bride and the bridesmaid, who are absolutely fantastic today, all three of you. And I've come to put your hands together for Emma and the bridesmaid. Some of you may have noticed during the service today that I actually looked really happy and I couldn't stop smiling. Well, that was only due to the fact that history's repeating itself like all over again. I mean, it was only 20 years ago when it sounded like you were sending Emma to bed with a dummy. 25 years later, it's happening all over again. Now, I do have some short messages from some people that couldn't afford to make it today. I've been told to say that they wish you all the best, Dean, and for you not to be a stranger, they've not seen you for a few months. And that's from Annie Stacey and Brittany from Crystal Maine in Denton. Before I get started on Dean, I actually genuinely want to say a few words about Emma. Yeah? Now, for those who don't know Emma, you'll agree with me that she's beautiful, intelligent, funny, caring, ambitious.
Who's this, sorry?
Sorry, Emma, I can't be right here. You know, I'm not saying that, I didn't believe that. Now, growing up with Dean, he actually genuinely has been a really good brother to me and Mike. And it's an honour that he's asked me to be his best man today. He did ask Matthew as well, but he ain't got the balls to stand here and do a speech. Growing up with him must have been eventful to say the least, and I actually want to give you a few examples of why he's been eventful. First and foremost, I remember Joe when we was obviously there's 4 years between us, between the age of about 12 and 16. And we no longer need a babysitter at night. Mum and Dad obviously every Friday night, we went to the pub, and we was on countdown every week. As soon as you shut that front door, all hell broke loose. Mattresses were down the stairs, we were fighting, WWE wrestling, and it was most of the weekends we were playing cricket in the house because Michael was cricket and all the cricket back out. And all his friends came over. Where are we up to? So one weekend that Dean was in bat, and for those of you that don't know, Dean is very shit at sport. And he hit the ball and he smashed a light in the living room, and he was panicking like that. Because growing up, my dad finds us a flick around the air ball every now and then, and Dean was frightful that he was going to get one. So me being the younger, intelligent brother, I decided that we could swap that light with the one on the wall because it was the same one. So I saved Dean a good idea, to be honest with you. That, by the way, that light's still broken. And then my personal favourite growing up was we used to like put Dean in bed sheets, believe it or not. Weirdly enough, we used to put him in bed sheets. We used to spin each other around and see who can stay on the feet the longest. Dean's not very good balance anyway, but Matty wrapped him in the bed sheets, couldn't see a thing, and I was polishing the floor. Made it extra slippery, didn't it, Dean? And so Dean decided he was going to slip his back. He's had a radiator and flew on all over, pissing everywhere. It was only probably about 5-6 minutes as mum and dad went out. Dean's crying his eye out because blood's everywhere, but he might just told him to scratch and just throw a pair and get on with it. And so we realised about 10-15 minutes later it wasn't going to stop. So unfortunately, I had to bring mum and dad, come back to the house, so Dean probably needs to go to A&E. Next one, next memory I've got, Dean, from secondary school. And most of you will agree, when you're the age of around 14, 15, 16, like, your appearance is everything. You want to impress all the lads at school, all the girls at school. But did that go with Dean? Definitely not. I mean, you want to wear any tight clothes, you have the top of the range phone, and you know, you're those bollocks. But Dean used to get to school in a totally different method than everyone else. I mean, he'd go get the bus, or the walk, or get the parents to drop him off. But this is Dean, as we used to call him, used to rock up in roller skates. Yeah? And believe it or not, from some 1.4 miles away from our house to the edge of the park, Dean used to get there in about 6 minutes. He used to race my dad in the car and beat him. I don't know if that's because Dean was exceptionally quick on him, or because my dad's not learning how to get in third gear yet. But either way, there's not many things I've been jealous about Dean in my life, but that's definitely one of them. The next one, I've like been wondering how in do I put this in, does it cross a certain line, but in the end I've got it. When you get to a certain age, as boys, we'll understand that we've got testosterone on full throttle and we've come to get like a bit curious, to say the least. But this gentleman happens in our teenage years, you know, 14, 15, 16. But Dean, being different than everyone else, to say the least, wasn't a sheep, didn't fall over and all. He used to shake the bed. Now, we all know I used to share a room with Dean. My mum didn't know I had his own room and I had one bed with Dean. I was on the top one. And seriously, I was only about 6 or 7 years old, so Dean was only about 8 or 9. I used to get in bed ready for, I was at Corrie at the time, at primary school. And the bed would shake. I was absolutely baffled at what was going on. So, me being a younger brother, I used to like, be a little grass and on the balls. I shout down the other night, "Dad! Dad! Dean's shaking the bed!" That way, they're like, "Damn!" And I'm going to shout up every night, "Dean! Dean! I'll chop you up!" Sometimes I'll take you to the police station and I'll be like, "I should have passed the muscle on that ball." I'm trying to go to sleep because Mr. Isle's not going to be after tomorrow. Either way, it did stop Dean until he'd actually finished. To be honest with you, we always say we're the right wanker. One of the other memories is obviously on the way to school, on the way home to school, and he used to get a bus before he figured out how to do his roller skates. And he used to be a right back. I mean, there was one time, and I'm sure Dean will tell you later on, like, he used to, you have a yellow line with the bus driver, used to just like, just stand and talk to the bus driver. And Dean walked at some buttons above the door and he's like, "Oh, you know what Dean's like, he's probably wondering what they do." So he pressed it, it was an emergency exit for the front doors on the bus. So the bus is going down Stockport Road about 25, 30 miles an hour and the doors are open. So he decides to jump off. Now, most people in here who understand the laws of physics and understand if you jump off the bus, you're going to end up falling the way the bus has gone. Well, Dean did, he jumped off and started trying to run the opposite direction. So he jumped off the bus, tried to run the opposite direction, and he's literally rolling down the road, bruises and cuts all over his back, something you'd actually see in a Bruce Willis action movie. Genuinely, I do wish I had a video of it, because I'm a bit skinned, and you do pay me 250 quid for it all day long. And there was his friend on the bus, the A14, the school bus, or 307, the sort of floor, whatever bus he got on, Dean used to have this weird friend. Now, everyone on the bus would look at Dean, like, a bit curious, I think. A bit special, this kid. But everyone would look around and they could hear him. I presume it was because of the noise levels, I genuinely don't know. But Dean, I actually managed to find my best friend today. Yeah? So, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to announce Makita. fancied Dean's best friend at the age of around 13, 14. And for those of you that might know, Dean used to get on the double decker bus, sit at the back, and play Encore Mr. Lonely everyone on the bus to listen to. Now you can understand why everyone wants to a bit furiously. Right, I think that's probably enough about me. The last part of the speech, I'd like to offer some guidance to both Dean and Emma about how marijuana should work. Now, I'm no expert on this, but I have made some observations from my time growing up so far. So, firstly, this is guidance for Dean about Emma.
That's Emma, by the way.
Yeah? So, wife really does like surprises. This is his name, I'm not sure wife do like surprises. But Dean, it's your job to know what the wife likes surprises and her favourite kind of surprises will go to buy. Dad, you need to tell you no this for the moment on this one. It's a husband's job to organise a surprise party and keep her informed of every single detail about it. And finally, it's important for the husband to pretend he had no wife before he was married. Guys, I understand you know exactly what I'm talking about. But especially if he was married before he was married. But Dean, for this reason, it doesn't really apply to you because you actually had no wife before Emma. Now, Emma, I've got some guidance to you about me. This is Dean, by the way, I don't know if you've met him. This is your husband. Now, for those who now know Dean, I understand it does look very, very complicated. In actual fact, he's very, very simple to say. Dean, Emma, all you've got to feed him is candle corn and candle twirl. And the husband has a very, very good memory. He can remember all his favourite foods, remember he's got a big plate, and even his old car registration plates. He might not remember anything that he asked for, and like what he picked him up from the shop, what he asked him to pick up from the shop. Well, this is because his brain is full, and not because he's not been listening to it. Now, I need to get something to say something. There's a massive difference between siblings and brothers. Brothers are there for each other when you need them most. Seniors are our highs and our lows. One of the greatest joys about my life was growing up with two brothers. And after the fighting, finally becoming friends. While speaking about this speech, I actually started to think about what makes a brother. You know, I was like, what is a brother? And you were sitting on your brother, and you were a brother. Same as Matthew. We share inside jokes, we stay up late at night at home, and no one's at bed when they know that's going on. Brothers understand what parents don't know won't hurt them. Brothers understand that fighting at the table means you're going to have to wash the pots. But if you think you can do it quietly, then you can stitch the other up and blame it on them.
Yeah.
And they will do the pots. But we soon come to notice if you blame it on mum, no, you're definitely doing the pots. Brothers share childhood memories and our future dreams. And we are here celebrating today, Dean moving on to the next stage of his life. And I feel like this is the perfect opportunity to tell you how proud I am of you and how you've become. You are one of the greatest guys I know. You're a grafter, you're an amazing dad, and you're an absolute heart of gold. You deserve so much, and I wasn't happy to find happiness with Emma. You two should truly deserve each other, and all the joy and happiness that will come your way. Honestly, one's best man's duty means that I was with Dean last night and his last night in freedom. And we didn't time until long post. He actually spent his time telling us how much he's going to be a good husband to you and how he's looking forward to going to the honeymoon to Wales.
Not going Wales?
No. Alright, well, that's funny because you told me you were going to banker for a week.
Like in your eyes, I see my face.